now because we're in a show business mode here. Newly arrived from Midtown Manhattan traffic in the spotlight, she is the first lady of rap, but Brooklyn native Lil' Kim's career took a bit of a detour when she was sent to prison for perjury in 2005.
Now Kim has served her time and has created a foundation to help those who need it the most. Please welcome Lil' Kim, and from the National Alliance to End Abuse, Jean Chateau. It's a thrill to, Jean, welcome, and it's a thrill to see you, Lil' Kim. Please tell me a little bit about your foundation.
Oh, well, Lil' Kim Cares. Right now, we're doing an auction, which is going to go to children.
Benefit a lot of Kim's charities.
Yes, yes.
And we have some of the items that are going to be auctioned off there. Can you tell
Absolutely.
Us about
it? What we're going to do over there is we have an authentic autographed basketball from Mr. LeBron James himself, who has been very gracious in helping to support Kim throughout this whole cause. We also have a signed autographed bottle of new fragrance from Sean Combs.
Yes.
Right?
Yes, and a nice, beautiful gold handbag from my friend, Kamor Lee Simmons.
So we're excited.
You could fit in there.
Yeah, I probably could.
I mean, Kim not included.
Yeah.
And if folks want more information on how to contribute and get involved, they can go to our website, myfoxny.com.
Right, and www.nationalalliances.com to get into the website. We also have a ultimate football fan package from the Baltimore Ravens. Monday Night Football,
sounds
your
great.
VIP treatment is incredible.
Okay. Hey, Lil' Kim, we want to get your opinion on something. The story of Imus and his outrageous comments. You heard what he said probably by this point. What do you think of his comments and what should happen to him?
Well, you know, that's why stuff like this is so important. And in light of all that, I want to say, you know, congratulations to the girls for winning the game.
That's just overlooked with all this going on.
But a lot of folks say, even though Imus is a jerk and what he said was horrible, he felt safe saying those things because of the kinds of music lyrics, and we've looked at some of your lyrics, that he feels safe because it's in the mainstream culture because it comes from... Do you feel partly responsible for the climate, I guess?
Well, guess what? We didn't say it.
Right, and it's not okay, and that's our national campaign.
Why is it okay to be in music if it's not okay to be repeated?
Because there's
I'd like to get Kim's opinion.
I think that's a double standard because we're not the ones who said it. I mean, what makes two wrongs right? If that's how you feel, I don't feel like that.
Well, the double standard would be saying that you can say it, but he can't.
Well, I don't...
Well, he's saying that you can say it, but he can't.
Right.
What is the difference
there? You didn't say it about the Rutgers basketball team. Certainly.
Exactly. So
and we
are
very happy they won.
You know, that's the problem. You know, we need to end all this racism and all this negativity.
And it's not okay.
Period. So that's not okay. So, I mean, you know, let's just shed light on these girls and say congratulations.
Congratulations.
Beautiful black girls.